Now let's move on to liabilities. Liabilities are something that you owe to other parties, meaning something that you're obliged to pay to other parties. As I said before, assets put money in your pocket, liabilities will take out money from your pocket. Examples of liabilities are accounts payable, also referred to as AP, and we have interest and we have taxes as liabilities. Let us discuss one by one. So what is accounts payable? Accounts payable is the amount we owe to other parties for the things that we bought from them or for the services we received from them. Okay, other parties can include suppliers or anybody. Accounts payable is a liability because we have an obligation to pay them back. And since we're paying them back, it takes out the money from the business. Okay. And we have interest. Interest is another liability. We have to pay money for the loans that we've taken, for the mortgages that we have taken on properties, so on and so forth. Since we are paying out money in the form of interest, interest is called a liability. And then we have taxes like income tax, value add tax, sales tax, property tax. These are all also considered as liabilities because we make payments in the form of tax. Like we have current assets and long-term assets, we do have current liabilities and long-term liabilities. Okay, the word current in the business world means within a fiscal year, right? So when we say current liabilities, it means that we are obliged to pay within the current fiscal year. Let's look at the examples of current liabilities. We have accounts payable. We have accrued liabilities. We have debt that needs to be paid within a year. And we have taxes that needs to be paid within a year. These are all current liabilities. We have discussed about accounts payable and we have discussed about taxes and we have discussed about interest, but we have not discussed about accrued liabilities. Let me clear what it means. Accrued as a word means accumulation over time. Accrued liabilities mean the payments that have been accumulated over a period of time, which were not paid and are to be paid within this current year. So, since you're making those payments which you were supposed to pay in this current year, it is called current liability. Okay. So let's look at the long-term liabilities. To put it simple, anything that needs to be paid not in this current year is a long-term liability. It could be the interest payments on loans, mortgages, cars, or the loans that have been taken for machinery, equipment, land, anything that is being paid in the next fiscal year, or something that has been spread across multiple fiscal years is called a long-term liability. And like we have tangible assets and intangible assets in assets category.
Under liability section, we do not have tangible liabilities or intangible liabilities. What we have is something called contingent liabilities. But the important point to remember is contingent liabilities can be a part of current liability or a long-term liability depending upon the situation. But most likely, contingent liabilities are a long-term liability. Let me explain what a contingent liability is for. The money that is kept aside for unforeseen future events are called contingent liabilities. Some of the examples, if I have to quote, are lawsuits. Companies need to keep some money aside for any unforeseen lawsuits that they may get into. And the money that is kept aside for such events are called contingent liabilities. Other examples are product warranties. When companies sell products, they need to provide warranty services for the products they sell. And the money that is kept aside for such warranty issues are called contingent liabilities.
Likewise, we also have some of the companies that offer benefits such as post-retirement pensions. Those are again the liabilities which fall under
contingent liabilities.
Okay. Do you remember Galaxy Note 7 recall? It costed about $5.6 billion for that recall. And I call the recall from hell. Okay. because it's a whooping $5.6 billion for a phone recall, right? Companies can go out of business if things go haywire, because Samsung is a big company, it was able to afford that recall. And there are many companies which have gone bankrupt because of product recalls. Anyway, you get the idea. The money set aside for such purposes are called
contingent liabilities.
Now let's look at the other crucial elements of accounting, which is capital.